Alright guys, so now the last thing to do to the 2011 with my old stuff on it is to swap out the battery, because this one, I'm not sure the last time like it was really used, but I mean I have an idea, because the stickers on the old plastics, the last time, when they expired was 2014, and this is a 2011, so... It was definitely sitting a while, because this battery's stone dead, so I'm gonna get it swapped out, and then hopefully she fires up. So my phone died, but I did get this one all the way together, and the seat's all on it now. I got all the Walker's Evans shocks in this, and it definitely sits higher. And then I can definitely tell that this one sits lower. It was a big difference, which kind of surprises me. I kind of thought that they were going to be about the same, but that thing sits way higher than this. And I mean, I don't got a motor in that, so I can't do like a full comparison, because that one's probably missing like at least 100 pounds off of the front, maybe 150. So I can't really do a full comparison, but like it sits way higher. Like they're both just sitting flat on the ground. This one's even closer, so it's hard to see, but like that one sits way up there compared to this one. You even look at the control arms, you guys can see the difference. And just like stepping on to the back, it's a lot higher. So you guys can see there, and then on the mine. So this thing's gonna be a lot of fun this winter. I think it looks really good with the seat on there and how everything's blacked out. I'm really liking the look of it. It was definitely worth doing the swap. And then that one, I mean, it actually looks pretty good with the extra red on it. I think that was what it needed. You know, it's still the just regular plastics and stuff, so, you know, you're not going to get the extra money for it, but it's still a nice sled, because all this stuff only had 500 miles on it. Same with the shocks. You know, 6 years old, 500 miles, not too bad. I did notice that the shocks off of this, though, since this thing had 3,000 miles on those shocks, the bushings were getting pretty wore. So I tried to switch out the bushings that I could. I know I for sure did the one on the track. The bushings on those shocks, though, they were, like, so good still that, like, I couldn't get them off. So... the front shocks are a little loose, but they'll hold up for probably as long as I'll own it. And so, yeah, this thing's looking good. But now, it's on to that. That's all that's left now, is to get into this, which I don't know why I, you know, waited on. But, oh well, we're here now, and let's get her done. All right, guys, it's teardown time. So I just found something pretty interesting.
Look at these head studs. So I just took the head off right there. And all that is on the inside. That is not cool. Let's see here. Oh, the cylinders look really nice still. That's always a good sign. Alright, well, we'll keep going. I just wanted to show you guys that. Like, look at how gross those are. I'm gonna have to find out what causes that. Well, gotta make sure that I get everything cleaned out. Which I was planning on anyways, but... Man. Alright. This is how far I got it tore down. I got all the bolts on the bottom loose. Something's still holding it right here because it's not wanting to split. It's split down there, but not right here. So I think there might be something in there or whatnot. Probably want the flywheel off anyways if for when it splits. And then here's everything else that came off, the cylinder and all that good stuff. So I'll get the flywheel puller and get that pulled off. Alright guys, it's time to pull the flywheel off here. So I got these long bolts that are the same thread that will just thread in right there. And then this is actually the flywheel puller. And you put the bolts in there and then it goes on right there. And then it has that thing that goes on the end. And it just pulls this off of the crankshaft. So I'm going to get that all set up and then get this flywheel pulled off for you guys. Alright, so when you get it set up, it should look just like this. As you can see, not much of this is sticking out. But you want these bolts right here turned in enough, like, I don't know, like 5 turns or something. Because you definitely don't want to pull those threads out. And then you also want to make sure that they're equal and everything's lined up. And then you just put like a impact or something on there, or and then tighten it, and then it should just pop this right off as long as you got enough power to turn this. So I'll show you guys that now. All right, let's see if we can get this thing to come off. Nope, we need some more power. So I had to break out the air impact. So let's get this thing off. Just like that. Take your little bolts out. All right, and then just pull this right off. It's gonna be kind of on there still because it's magnetic. And your stator's on the inside. So all that in there is a magnet. That's what charges your stator, which keeps your battery charged when you're out riding and when it's running. Pretty much just like an alternator on a car. And these little two things are your crank position sensors because it's EFI. And that'll like just tell you, like, make sure it's running good. I don't know too much about them exactly, but that's the gist of it. And so, definitely this thing still holding it together because it's a circle around the case right there. You can see where it splits on both sides. So I gotta pop my stator off now, pull all of it out, and then we can split the case. And then actually, if you guys look over here, it looks like it's supposed to ride right there. Oh, there you guys go. Looks like it's supposed to ride right there, and I think that much of it came out of the case. Like, that's a good finger width, because the starter won't hit the clutch gear anymore when it was spinning. So I'm pretty sure the crank end actually popped out of the case, like, at least a quarter of an inch, it looks like. So let's get that off and see what the damage is. All right, guys, so I got the stator all unbolted, and now it should just come right apart, so.